Hi, this is Tom checking in for techstrike.co.uk. Today I'm going to show you Logic 3's iStation Rotate, which is a speaker dock for iPod Touch and iPhone. So let's take a closer look. Inside we have instruction manual, actual dock itself. Get the iPhone plug, then you just take off the lid here. Works quite easily. On the back we have a battery port and some swivel out legs. Quite handy for putting on a desk or whatever. Complete with that we have Logic 3 carry case, remote control for the dock, and we have a travel plug which comes with two interchangeable connectors, a British one and a European one, which is quite handy. You don't need to go out and buy an adapter if you want to go abroad. A selection of 8 cradles, from everything from the iPod Classic range to the iPhone 3G. And finally, a lining connector. As I'm about to show you, setting up's quite easy. First of all, take off the lid like so. Then you select your appropriate cradle for your iDevice. Pops in quite easily. Pop in your music player, slide to the right, rotate to the left. Unfortunately, setting up the remote control isn't quite as easy at first. As you can see, I've had a few problems even getting the lid open. The battery is quite a flimsy fit. It's prone to popping out every now and then. As you can see, I'm not doing too well. Eventually pop it in. But as you can see, I'm having problems getting the lid shut. And eventually get it closed, but it bulges out of the back of the remote a little bit. For those of you who don't have an iPod Touch or an iPhone, all is not lost. As you see, it won't be able to plug into the main connector on the dock, but it comes with a lining cable which plugs into the back of the speakers. Very easy to set up. Just plug in at the back, like so. Hook up to your other portable music player. Press play. Playing back music is very easy using the iStation Rotate. Just pop in your iPod or iPhone, like so, select the music player, select a track, and press play. Unfortunately, scrolling through your music library in landscape orientation is a bit more difficult. As you can see, I'm having great difficulty using the remote control, and eventually just give up and use the touchscreen again. Video playback's pretty good. The sound quality is very clear, and there's no noticeable lag between what you're seeing on the actual screen and what's coming out of the speakers.
Pairs of socks I buy and never seem to have any.
Sir, with your forgiveness, there is another even weightier problem.
They just disappear! Honestly!
I was interested to find out how well the iStation could cope with sound playback from apps. As you can hear, it's doing a pretty good job. It's perhaps not the most practical way of playing on your iPhone or iPod Touch, but it's an interesting addition. So in conclusion, the iStation Rotate is certainly a very good attempt by Logic 3 to cater for the needs of the ever-increasing iDevice audience. Their Rotate concept certainly stands out from other dock competitors, and the accessory appeals to the overall aesthetic design of the iPod Touch iPhone itself. The device isn't perfect, however. There are a few flaws that Logic 3 needs to iron out. First of all, they seriously need to update their device cradles, and they also need to provide a less time-consuming remote control. However, the portability and the reasonable audio balance certainly make up for these flaws. The iStation Rotate is ideal if you're a domestic user who wants reasonably good sound quality but with the added convenience of space. I do hope you've enjoyed this review. Please check out the written review as well, as I haven't had time to go through everything in this video, and there are a couple of things that I do brush up on. For instance, I've given some feedback regarding the video output on the back of the device, which does very well, as well as a couple of other things.